Everything good, everything bright, everything holy, everything right, everything worthy, all that I should. And all is well, 'cause I'm gonna dwell on everything.
There are walls made by men, built with frail and human hands.
Tonight to know that He is the one that answers the prayer.
Yes,
hallelujah.
If
we'll just bring it to Him,
hallelujah,
and we'll have faith to see that God can do it. I like that song because it says there's walls of grace and there's walls of faith. But the one that makes all those strong is the wall of prayer. Mm-hmm. We need prayer in our lives and we need to seek the Lord like never before. Praise the Lord. And that's what we're going to share. The Lord laid this on my heart. If you turn to your Bibles in Genesis chapter 18. Genesis 18. We're going to start at verse 23. Praise the Lord. Genesis 18. 23. And it says, and Abraham drew near and said, wilt thou also destroy the righteous with the wicked? Peradventure there be 50 righteous within the city. Wilt thou also destroy and not spare the place for the 50 righteous that are therein? That be far from there to do after this manner, to slay the righteous with the wicked, and that the righteous should be as the wicked. That be far from thee. Shall not the judge of all the earth do right? Praise the Lord. Let's pray. Lord, we're thankful, Jesus, for your word. We're thankful, Jesus, that we're here tonight. Though we're few in number, we know, God, that you are here. And Lord, we're asking, God, that you would touch us tonight. And Lord, give us a special touch, Lord, that we need. Lord, we know, God, that every time that we come into the sanctuary, we are blessed, Lord, and you have blessed us. And Lord, I pray, God, as your word goes forth tonight, that you would use me, God, to touch lives, Lord, to touch us, that we won't be the same, but we'll be changed in Jesus' name. Lord, I pray, God, that you would speak and you would move, Lord, in a special way in our lives. And we ask it in the mighty name of Jesus. And everyone said,
amen.
Amen. Now, if you don't know the story that I am referring to in this scripture, I want to share it with you. This is the story of Sodom and Gomorrah. You can just imagine, we've probably all heard of the city there where the wickedness was so great that God was through with the city. Can you imagine a nation, a country that was founded on God, our nation that I'm talking about tonight, and that we need God in our lives? I pray that it won't turn to this. But I pray that you would see that there was one standing in the gap here. Yes. I want you to look at the man called Abraham. He was standing in the gap and he went to the Lord. And I want you to know that God revealed to him that he was through with Sodom and Gomorrah. I want you to know, in the same way, God is revealing to us that there are needs and that he is calling us to prayer. He is calling us to intercession, and he is calling us to leave the things of this world aside and to get alone with him and to know, hallelujah, that we can have conversation with the Lord God Almighty. Hallelujah. What a wonderful thing. Amen.
Hallelujah.
To know that we can take every need, that we can talk with the Lord, just as you talk with your friend over the phone or you call someone up. You can talk to Jesus Christ. You can talk to God and know that he will hear you.
Amen.
If you're saved, if you're blood bought, if your sins are under the blood of Jesus Christ, you have access to the throne tonight.
Amen.
Hallelujah. That's a wonderful thing. I think a lot of times we take that for granted. We need to know, and I pray, are you a Abraham tonight? Are you interceding and are you coming before the Lord? See, Abraham knew that he had family members in that city. He had loved ones. He knew that Lot was over there and that he did not want to see them destroyed. He did not want to see his family members be lost. But he went before the Lord and he brought his petition before the Lord. God is calling us to do the same thing.
Yes.
He is calling us that we would cry out to him. And it's wonderful to know in this scripture where God revealed it unto Abraham. He let him know what he was going to do. He gives us warning signs.
Yeah.
You know, I sensed this week or the week before, right at the end, I don't know of anything. But see, the Spirit can sometimes speak to someone and reveal, as I am the leader of this church, that we need to seek the Lord.
Amen.
I am the voice crying out that we need to pray and seek him.
Yeah. Praise you, Jesus.
God sometimes speak. You know, it don't have to be an audible voice. It don't have to be something loud. Just that sweet Spirit that speaks to us and says, it's time to pray. It's time to come to me. You know, a lot of times we don't realize that our prayers that we can't even see, or we don't realize what he's doing. A lot of times we're saying, God, why aren't you doing something? Why is it something taking place? But see, a lot of times just like he did for Lot that day. Abraham cried unto the Lord. You know, it's something when you have someone, and I thought of it this today when I was thinking of this sermon. You might be the only Abraham for your family. You might be the only Abraham that can go to the Lord and seek for their behalf. Come on, let's think about it tonight. Who's praying for your loved ones? Who's going to pray for them? Who's going to stand before the Lord and seek and intercede for them? I thought about it the other day. I thought, Lord, who's praying for my family? Who's standing in the gap? Yeah, maybe there are someone out there. I pray. It's a wonderful thing to know that someone's praying for you, isn't it? Mm-hmm. It's a wonderful thing to know that someone's standing before the Lord. I think of Brandon there. When he said that, you know, years ago he was in that car accident. That was God. That was God. And a lot of times we don't see, you know, I've heard of testimonies later on where there was times where the Lord spoke to someone, got them out of bed. They were sleeping, but they were stirred in their spirit. The Lord woke them up to pray, and later they found out that God, through their prayers, had kept their family or kept their loved one from destruction, just as Lot. You know, because see, Abraham went before God. You know, that's what we need to do. It says here in 23, Abraham drew near. It's a wonderful thing that we've got to have that close and that intimate time with the Lord. We've got to stand and we've got to conversate with Him. It's what's going to help us. It's what's going to help our faith. It's what's going to keep us from this world and keep us from the tricks of the devil. I want you to know the devil, he's got some tricks up his sleeve. And it's the only thing that's going to keep us is when we pray and we intercede and we stand. Yes, I know it's not an easy thing to do, but I guarantee you it is a rewarding thing that when we pray and we look to the Lord, it gives us, you know, I think of Abraham. He had confidence. You know, you can have confidence in Jesus Christ.
Yes.
Jesus Christ has cleansed us and delivered us from all of our sin. And because of that, we can come to Him. As it says in Hebrews, we can come boldly to the throne of grace.
Amen.
What a wonderful thing to know. And you know, just as Abraham, he pleaded his petition. He said, if there be 50 there, Lord, would you still kill the righteous with the wicked? And God replied, no, I won't destroy them. And he kept going further. See, that's what we've got to do. We can't just say one prayer and then it be done. No, we got to keep going at it. We got to keep pushing through until we get an answer. Until the answer comes. Looking to know that Abraham was that intercessor for his family. He trusted in the Lord and he knew that God would see them through. And that's what we've got to do tonight, to know that when we come to the Lord, He is listening and He hears our cry unto Him. Have you ever cried unto the Lord? Have you? Have you cried unto the Lord? I was reading in Psalms where it says, this poor man cried, and the Lord heard him and saved him out of all his troubles. From the end of the earth will I cry unto thee. When my heart is overwhelmed, lead me to the rock that is higher than I. We've got to go higher than, you know, what our thinking is. We've got to go higher than, you know, what we think that's best for us. We've got to know the only thing that is going to help us is when we turn to the Lord and we seek Him. It's our responsibility. You mean we have responsibility as Christians? Yes, we do. We have responsibility that God wants to do great things in us. And the only way that they're going to happen is when we take it by force. I was reading there in Ephesians where it says, praying always with all prayer and supplication in the Spirit. And watching thereunto with all perseverance and supplication for all saints. Praying for one another. Do you think of your brother that sits beside you? Do you think, you know, I don't want this just to become a religious thing where we just come to church and then we've done our duty for the week. No, this is a relationship where we seek the Lord and we come to Him and we know that He will answer our prayer if we're faithful.
Amen.
If we're faithful. Philippians 1:19 says, "For I know that this shall turn to my salvation through your prayer and the supply of the Spirit of Jesus Christ." I'm thankful for the Holy Spirit. Because a lot of times, you know, you can get down and you can begin to pray. And a lot of times you can find your mind, you know, all over the place. But oh, I'm so thankful for the power of the Holy Spirit that comes and He does the intercession.
Yes, amen.
He will come down. There wasn't many here last night, but where two or three are gathered together in my name, He's in the midst. And when we pray and seek the Lord, God will do the great and mighty things.
Amen.
We've got to be encouraged. We can't give up. We can't give in. We've got to know that He will do it if we look to Him. And the Lord, you know, I was reading in this scripture where the Lord sent the angels into the city to save Lot. But not only Lot, He didn't just say one. He said, but all of Lot's family. That's why it's so important that we know that He will intervene, that He will bring it to pass in our lives if we put our trust in Him, and to know that our family, our loved ones, those that are lost out there in sin, those that need a healing, it could be just one prayer, one prayer, one breakthrough. How many's ever prayed and you know that you prayed through?
Amen.
I have had times where, yes, I got up and I didn't feel that full, you know, that I prayed through. But there's been other times where I knew that I prayed through to God.
Amen.
And He heard my prayer. And He hears your prayers. And that's what's going to help our church. That's what's going to bless this church. That's what's going to bless your family. That's what's going to keep your children. I want you to know, it's our prayers. It's seeking the Lord. I think of my dad that prayed. And I guarantee it's the reason why I stand behind this sacred desk. It's because someone prayed for me.
Amen.
That delivered me from the hands of the devil.
That's right.
That kept me through the years and even tried to take my life. But I stand here healed. I stand here delivered and set free. I need Jesus just as much as you do. And I need prayer in my life just as much as you do. What's going to help us? It's what's going to see us through this dark world. It's what's going to see our families. You want your family to be at this altar and to give in to the power of the Holy Spirit and to surrender their lives? Begin to pray. Begin to seek the Lord. Just as Abraham did. He didn't give in. He didn't give up. He went before the Lord over and over and over. To make that petition before the Lord. Would you deliver? Would you set free? Would we take the time?
Yes.
to seek the Lord. These are days of grace and mercy, and these are days to be found praying and seeking the Lord. See, we don't realize even the things that are going on in the spiritual. You don't tell me, even as we put in a new president and all the evil that is coming against it. And like someone said, it's not just about a man. This is our country. This is our nation that was founded on the truths of Jesus and of God. That's why we need His Spirit tonight to lift us up. And to encourage us to know that if we will pray, it might just be you. Like I said, remember, you might be the only Abraham in your family. What would have happened to Lot and his family if it had not been for Abraham going to the Lord and seeking the Lord on their behalf? God is calling us to seek Him and to pray. And when we don't get the answer, to keep on praying and to seek Him, to know that it will come to pass if we put our trust in the Lord. Can you say amen?
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Let's stand.
Everything good, everything bright, everything holy, everything right, everything worthy, all that I should.